Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Roxbury Community College.
Welcome, everybody, to this NJCAA matchup between the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. You're watching Bayhawks men's basketball against the Roxbury Community College Tigers. And I'm David Cardoza here on the play-by-play. Next to me is Craig Salvador. Craig Salvador, we get a great matchup here tonight, 8 p.m. Big crowd here on end. Big crowd here for today. Oh, nice run the back pass off the top by Quincy Pope, your man right there. Wow. To get it to Desmond Jernigan for the score.
5 seconds in the game already with the flashy plays.
BCC comes in at 10-3, 10-3 in Region 21. Roxbury coming in on a 10-game losing streak. They're at 2-14, 2-10 in the conference, and they only come in with 5 players, and that ball is way off, rebounded by Jose Mercado.
Yeah, I was going to say, we're definitely not going to be seeing the battle of the benches in this game.
No, it's going to be an easy game to call because, oh, nice pass by McCarthy to Baker, lays it in off the glass. Nice scoop, nice finger roll. And BCC, we know, they got a big deep team. BCC at full power, we assume, here tonight, full strength.
And Roxbury coming with almost no team other than the guys on the court.
Stolen by Jose to Jernigan. Alley-oop, the slam!
Jose,
that's the way you do it in prime time.
Jose Mercado with the man bun power, bringing the house down.
The man bun power dunk. Beautiful, you can see it all the way. Imer Ortiz, handoff almost went awry. I like the sneakers by Roxbury. Spinning in the lane. Oh, nice. Rebound by Armani Baker getting up.
Armani Baker doing what he does best.
Which is the dirty work. McCarthy sets the play. Gives to Pope. He'll dump it into Baker at the elbow. Back to Pope for three. Gets it. Wow.
Pope making it rain the holy water early on.
At the Holy Castle, Bishop Connolly High School, home of your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, right next door to the campus, the beautiful campus of BCC. This one just underway, and it's a 9-0 lead for your Bayhawks. Spinning. Oh, nice up and under move, puts it up on the glass. Great job there.
Calling a travel on Pope. That was a great attempt. Definitely the right idea. Pope just couldn't get a shot off.
With the basketball, number 20. 15 on the shot clock. Driving is Ortiz. Puts it up. No good. Baker gets up high for the rebound. Going back the other way. Pope, no good. Baker comes in and gets another rebound. They'll reset the shot clock. Mercado dumps it in. Desmond Jernigan. And they're going to call steps.
Ooh. Yeah, Roxbury definitely going to have to play conservative basketball this game, only having 5 players.
This is kind of the opposite. In the women's game, it was the Bristol girls who were outmanned. Ortiz, the jumper in the corner, no good. Rebounded by Baker.
I think this is the lowest amount of people we've seen on a boys' team this season.
It sure is. Swinging in the corner. Mercado coming in easy. Quick first step. And the coach of Roxbury calling a timeout, 11-2 here early on.
I have been left by my broadcast partner. He is retrieving some important intel.
Always with the important intel.
He found the starting lineup for the other team.
Well, I have it. I'm not sure who number 20 is because number 20 is not. You know, we'll have to.
Well, who do they got? They got.
There's just no 20 on there, but we'll figure it out. Anyways, 11-2.
They got. Amir Ortiz, he's number 3. Number 5, they have Jabril Hassan.
Okay, but there's 0. No 20 on either roster. Anyways,
I know, I'm
11
trying to,
and 2.
I'm trying to cut it down. Cause
yeah, we'll cut it down. We'll figure it out. 11 and 2, BCC.
Okay, it's Lawrence Sherry, number 11 on our sheets. There's no number 11 over there, but there's a number 20.
Oh, there is number 11.
Yep, so maybe grab the wrong jersey. Yeah.
There's always one mystery player game, I swear, during these games. Anyway, BCC with 11-2 early lead. Driving in the lane, no good. Rebounded by Mercado. McCarthy at the point. McCarthy for 3. Nice rotation. It's good. Nice arc. Beautiful shot by McCarthy for 3.
Just had no defense on him. Could do whatever he wanted.
BCC coming up playing strong man-to-man. They're gonna wear the Tigers out like that. Tigers with no bench.
Exactly, no bench.
Oh, nice stutter step. Nice delay, nice stutter step there, but no can do by our mystery player there, number 20. They swing it. They get it to Baker. Jernigan.
Good swing motion from the Bayhawks.
BCC moving that zone around. Jernigan off the glass. Desmond Jernigan has worked his way into the starting lineup. 16-2.
This is something the Bayhawks are going to have to do, is really swing around, tire out this Roxbury team real quick. They can get an easy victory.
Roxbury has to do what the Bristol girls needed to do, which they failed to do, which kind of slowed the game down. Because there's no way they're going to be able to run with BCC, especially with 5 guys.
No.
The miss there by number 14, Pedro Ramos.
We have such a fast team, there's not going to be any outrunning.
Pope from the wing, 3-pointer, no good. Baker high for the rebound, puts it above the glass, tipped up and in. I think Jernigan came in for the tip. And it's 18-2 Bayhawks here. I'm going to say that's Jared Mosley. Because instead of 0, he's going to put a 2-0 on there.
No, but there's already a number 0.
Oh. It's like a game. It's like a game. Trying to figure out
who
number 20 is. McCarthy kicks it back out to Pope. Cross court.
Well, that was a great
Jose
pass.
Jose, can you 3? No good.
Despite the miss, that was a picture-perfect pass from Pope.
They had the shot they wanted. Jernigan with the rebound. Another miss by the Tigers. Only one field goal for them.
McCarthy trying to direct traffic.
McCarthy thought about it. Gets it to Mercado. Baker to Jernigan. Cutting to the basket. Beautiful execution.
Seen some great moves from Jernigan early on in this game. As you said, he's really worked his way into the starting
lineup. Yeah, he was one of the first guys off the bench. I mean, he's the guy that got playing time, but now he's a starter. Another thing, we've seen Danny Mendez, who was one of the leading scorers in the first handful of games for this team. Got him coming off the bench now.
Remember, there was a stretch of quite a few games where we didn't see Marcus McCarthy at all, and now he's also in the starting lineup.
Well, yeah, he's asserted himself, and he's back in the starting lineup where he was.
Shown himself as a great leader on the team, a great three-point shooter.
Well, he's their primary ball handler.
As you can see, he always directs traffic of the team, does really well with it.
I wouldn't say that's his natural position either. Jernigan to a cutting Baker to the lane. Gets his shot altered by Pedro Ramos. Ortiz for 3, pulls up and nothing but net.
So that's
20-5.
That's something Roxbury is going to have to do more often if they want any chance at this game.
They're going to need to shoot well from the outside, that's for sure. Mercado, cross-court pass to Pope. Pope back up to McCarthy, pulls up for 3, no good. Rebounded by Mercado, fall-away jumper, gets it.
There's something great with these Bayhawks. They can all rebound pretty much.
They can leap. Not exactly the tallest team.
Nope.
Got a bunch of tweeners, middle of the road guys.
And
as far as height is concerned.
They definitely got ups.
Shot clock winded down. That's what BCC forces you to do. And I think we're going to have a push off. It looks like it might be on Marcus McCarthy. No, I'm sorry. It's going to be on Armani Baker, his first.
And I was going to say, Bayhawks doing a good job isolating him, not letting the shot clock wind down, but ended up fouling him.
Yeah, exactly. That's great defense. In the passing lane. Going the other way. And a slam. Another slam by the Pope here in the Holy Castle.
Pope taking him to church.
That's sewn away by Baker. Baker in the open lane. Baker going to go for the... Oh, Baker lays it in, and BCC putting on a clinic. A clinic, 26-5. Things getting scary.
And timeout called.
And just as we've seen the Bristol girls kind of get their doors blown off in the first few minutes, same thing's happening on the Bristol men return the favor, this time to the men's.
I was going to say, the men's team really avenging the girls early on.
Yeah. 26-5. Goodness gracious. It's not going to get any better. BCC just looks like lightning quick right now. So Bristol Community College, they're 9-1 in their last 10 games. The one game that they lost, they were missing three of their pivotal players. Quincy Pope, Kevin Desire, and Jose Mercado missed the game against Bunker Hill, a team that they beat by 30 points early in the season. They lost 114-89. That's the one game they lost here in the last 10 games.
Well, we
looking to make it 10 of 11 now.
We still haven't seen Kevin Desire in a while.
With Desire. You have Desire for Desire.
Hey, I like to call Kevin Desire on fire, but we just haven't been seeing a lot of him.
Coach Rob Del Lue has different lineups, different rotations during the season. And just as you get your wish, here comes Kevin Desire coming in for Jernigan.
I just want to see him dunk.
We've already seen two dunks.
I know, but he jumps like the highest out of all of them. I think it's because he's the tallest.
Definitely a good athlete. Kevin Desire, soccer player, former soccer player. Turning in the lane was number 5. No good. Desire setting the pick.
It's a great pass to
Mendez for three. Gets it.
It's a great pass to Danny Mendez. Easy three.
How about Danny Mendez coming out the bench? Being like a little spark plug. Not that they even need it right now. 29-5. Driving is the mystery. No good. Altered by Desire. Mendez pushing it with his speed. Short mid-range jumper by Pope. No good. This guy, number 20, always has the basketball, too. Loses it. So 14 is Pedro Ramos. Number 5 is Jabri Hassan.
Like I said, I think
we have a number 11 out there as well.
Do they?
No, they don't.
That's what I said earlier on.
That's going to be Lawrence Cherry.
That's what I said earlier
on. He's Lawrence Cherry, number 20.
Dave, I said that 10 minutes ago.
Well, I'll take the credit. BCC.
I have no comment.
Cherry, no good. Rebounded by Desire. Another rebound by him.
And McCarthy's taking his time, and rightfully so.
Yeah. Mendez going baseline. Dishes it to Baker. No good. Rebounded by Hassan.
Well, Roxbury just rushing the play.
Roxbury has no business trying to get into a fast break, pushing up the court matchup. They just don't have the depth for that right now.
No, they will lose every time if they try that.
No, they just don't have the manpower right now. Not their fault. Driving. Looking to drive was Cherry.
A risky pass. Almost lost it.
Yeah, 10 on the shot clock. Three-pointer by Ortiz is missed. Rebounded by Mendes. BCC just looks so fast. A lot of energy by BCC here today.
Not quite sure what happened on that. I think Pope got it knocked out of his hands when he went up for the layup.
Yeah, kind of lost control of it. Baker coming out now. Juan Espinol, number three in the game for BCC.
You're talking about him. He's a new addition this second half.
He is our new addition, yes.
So definitely like to see how he can contribute.
Well, there's a reason he's out there and it's in the rotation. He actually started against Bunker Hill. Cherry always with the basketball, but not doing anything with it.
Shot clock's coming down. They got to do something.
Cherry is a ball hog. How is he always with the basketball? He's always with the basketball and never does anything positive with it.
No.
Here's Mendes. Mendes at the point. Number one for BCC. Jose Mercado now in the game. Desire shooting from the outside.
Don't see that too often.
On point, no good. Rebounded by Espinol, then loses it. Ortiz going to get fouled.
Oh. I was kind of surprised that Quincy Pope didn't put up that three. He passed it to Desire. Looked like he had a lot of time to throw one up.
Wanted to hook his boy up. Mendes with the steal off the inbound pass.
That was just a bad pass.
BCC always looking to go. There's the alley-oop to Espinol, but he can't connect. BCC has a lot of guys that are athletic. When they get out on the open floor, man, watch out. That's their game. I feel like when you slow BCC down and you force them to have to go into half court a lot, more than not, that's just not their game. Their game is pushing the basketball as soon as they get it and scoring in transition. Driving with a floater is Cherry. Off the front rim, rebounded by zero, Jared Mosley, sophomore forward. Tough to play basketball. If you ever play basketball and you only play with five guys, man, it's tough.
We've been talking about that all season with the girls only having six players. Now they don't even have the luxury of a sub. They only got five guys on the court.
There's nothing you can do. I mean, it's one thing if you're playing pickup basketball at the YMCA or outside or somewhere. It's different when you're playing a 40-minute game. And you're going against another team that has a roster that has like 15 players. Here's Mendes, buzzing like a bee, getting in. Oh, swatted away by...
Yeah, you're saying buzzing like a bee. Got swatted like a bee.
Swatted away by Mosley, yeah. Driving in, no good.
This is a great thing about BCC's defense is they're making Roxbury move so much.
Yeah, as Mosley goes in for the score. Looks like he got fouled. Big smile on his face now, Jose Mercado. 31-6. Three-point shot. No good by Mosley.
Just didn't really have anything else to do with it.
Definitely not. Getting inside. Desire off the glass. Using his body. Using his length over Mosley. 33-6. I'm surprised that a team like Roxbury, close to the ball, in the Boston area, can't get the manpower. Three-point shot is good by Jabri Hassan.
Yeah.
Stopping at the foul line on a dime is McCarthy. The jumper is good, 35-9.
I have to agree with you being surprised with this Roxbury roster because we talk about the girls being one of the best in the state and then the boys barely even able to field a team.
You keep shortchanging Roxbury. They're the national champions.
Best team in the state.
You said the state. The national champions is national. Marcus McCarthy with the basketball. But you are. They're right. They are the best team in the state. They're the best team in the region and the best team in the country. The Roxbury women's team. Mendes gets it to your boy Desire. Little hook. It's good. I think this might be a big game for Desire. think you might see him getting to double figures. I think he could do some damage down the interior. Roxbury just, I mean, I just don't know. I mean, you have other community colleges, though, down there in the Boston area, like Bunker Hill is one of them. They have a deep team. But I mean, I'm not sure what it is.
With this being such a short team, this is what the Roxbury coach has to do, is really use these timeouts wisely. It's not just giving them advice, it's giving them time to rest.
Well, they are resting. I mean, they're resting. And the coach has to coach. And Coach Rob Del Lue still doing his job, still instructing his team, coaching his team, up 37-9. No matter what the score is, no matter how much time is left, there's always coaching points. There's always teaching points. You know, you can't, you know, like Bill Belichick, what makes him such a great coach is that the game is never over.
Yeah.
Especially with all this time left, 37-9, you know, you can't teach your team to, you know, in any way take their foot off the gas.
Yep. Practice doesn't make perfect. Practice makes improvement.
That's right. All right, if you're just joining us, it's David Cardoza, myself, and the Portuguese Cowboy, Craig Salvador, here on the call. If you're watching Bayhawks basketball here on Channel 95 on your Comcast dial. Again, you can watch a lot of these Bayhawks games. You can watch them all on YouTube, the women and men's team. It's Cardoza and Salvador on the call.
Just go to youtube.com/ Bristol Community College. Should be right there.
There you go. I was looking for those words. All right, you're watching Bristol Community College basketball, Bayhawks basketball, because Bristol. Bristol Community College, changing the world learner by learner.
For over 50 years. Our camera woman giving me the keep going signal.
They want us to advertise.
Okay, I don't have a show currently, but when I do, you guys will be the first to hear it.
Oh, great. Desire. Wow. Couldn't get in there and get the rebound, but BCC ends up with the ball anyways. Three-point shot by Mendez. No good. That ball on the ground now. And I think it's going to stay here. I think it's going to be Tigers basketball or not.
Looks like it. Oh, he just disrespected the headband.
He just disrespected the headband?
Yeah, number zero, Jared Mosley. He just tossed the headband. He's like, I don't need this anymore.
Wasn't doing him any favors.
I mean, if he puts on a show, then we'll know why. It's like when LeBron took off his headband.
That's when you knew it was time.
Yep, the flops started coming and the rings started showing.
Here's Aymar Ortiz from the top. Bounces up and in, gets the roll, or gets the three-pointer. Or are they calling it a two? No, it's a three.
Yeah.
Ooh, McCarthy finding Mendez from the wing. He loves that shot. As you can see, three-pointer by Mendez.
That's a great little duo right there, Danny Mendez and Marcus McCarthy. Seeing some great passing and great shooting between these two.
And you talk about Mendez coming off the bench. That's his second three of the half. Cherry. Mendez is all over him like nothing.
Bad pass.
Loose ball. Fly into the basketball. The hustle. We have another new player, number 21. That's Pierre.
Just all these new players really depthening that bench.
Yeah, and Pierre and Espinol, they were... They played a lot against Bunker Hill when BCC was short man. Cherry for three. High for the rebound is Jernigan. And here comes BCC. Again, BCC always looking to push the basketball. That ball always moving crisply. McCarthy driving traffic. Directing traffic. Jernigan almost lost it. Mercado thought about a deep three. That's McCarthy for three. No good. Snatched out of the air by Jernigan going to the floor. This one should be BCC basketball. Tigers got the last one. So,
The Roxbury had a chance to get the ball on that one, but on the pass by Pope, it was bobbled. And if he was able to bring it down, that would have been an easy turnover. It was a great job keeping it in bounds.
Yeah. BCC being patient. Roxbury in that zone. Alley-oop. Oh, no good.
And again, Roxbury can't take it. They can't take advantage of this.
Well, they finally get the basketball. BCC taking forever with that possession. But it's good to see BCC with some patience.
Yeah, they realize they have a big cushion. You know, they've already pretty much outran this team. You know, they don't have to rush things at this point.
Well, they don't have to. They don't have to attack.
They can take time, plan out what they're going to do next.
17 on the shot clock. Drive it to his left. I think they're going to say he stepped out of bounds. Jabril Hassan. I think he steps out of bounds. BCC basketball. Pope in the corner to Baker. They got Jernigan flashing up top. Down low, inside. Baker with a little soft slam,
BCC working this zone very well, swinging it around everybody.
They are definitely shifting that zone, definitely moving the ball against the zone well and getting easy shots. In the lane, Cherry, no good. Rebounded by Mercado.
Took forever to fall, but we still got it.
McCarthy stopping at the free throw line, gets it inside to Jernigan. Another score, 44-12.
This is starting to look less like a basketball game and more like a homicide.
It's looking like the women's game. I'm telling you, it's the reverse women's game. Three-pointer falling away as Ortiz. Not a good shot. Brick. Now the Roxbury men are looking like the team that's overman. Jernigan going to get fouled. And I guess number 20 there, Jared Mosley. Not Jared Mosley. Lawrence Cherry. Goodness gracious. Had no choice but to foul him. Jernigan was off to the races. Alley-oop, slamming it down. Baker from McCarthy. Alley-oop City. Slam-a-jamma.
Bringing it down.
Another loose ball, another turnover. We're going to see another slam. Bring it down the house. Bring it down the castle.
And the crowd.
Jernigan.
And the crowd is loving it.
Boy, the crowd is getting their money's worth. They're getting a lot of high flying, a lot of fast break basketball, and a lot of slams. This is the most slams we've seen in the game this year, Craig.
Yeah, and it's not even the second half yet.
That could do a lot to energize a team. Not that BCC needs it. Roxbury can't buy a bucket right now. Pushing it up the court. Swinging in the corner. Mercado down inside of Jernigan. And they're gonna say that he stepped out of bounds.
You're talking about Roxbury not being able to buy a bucket. They're not getting a lot of shots, but the ones that they are taking, they're just missing.
And BCC, they're getting anything they want on offense. They're able to create any shot, and it's unselfish basketball. They're moving around the ball around the perimeter. They're working the ball inside. You're seeing nice, clean passes. BCC really showing why they're the best team in Region 21 right now. In the corner for three, no good. Another rebound coming off. Mercado breaking away. Pope throwing an alley-oop. Oh, my goodness. BCC putting on a clinic. You can see the smiles out there.
Yeah, that's how you know they're comfortable. Even if they miss a play, they still know that they got this all day.
Exactly, and as you say that, going to the rim and getting the basket, but that was an awful fall, not a good fall.
This is very bad for Roxbury.
I think he's fine. He's up. Yeah. Jabril Cherry.
I mean, with this, maybe he'll pass the ball a little more.
Desire got psyched out. He was going to the table to check in. And Coach Del Lu says, no, Mendez is going in. So Mendez will go in. He's out there with the number 11, Jose Mercado, number 13, Quincy Pope, number 14, Amarni Baker, and number 23, Marcus McCarthy.
Danny Mendez is a hot shooter this half.
He's definitely a damn good shooter. 48-15.
Like I said, maybe we'll see it here soon, but I like the passing game Marcus McCarthy had to Danny Mendez earlier.
Yeah. How about the passing altogether by BCC? Short jumper by Mercado with the elbow. Tipped in. No good by Baker. Baker knew he had one.
BCC is really showing in this game is they have great positioning. It just seems like that the right guy is in the right place at all times in this game for BCC.
BCC always find the open guy. Nice find. Pope.
So even if it doesn't fall, it's still the best find they could have done.
Driving all the way to the hole. Jabril Cherry for a lay-in. BCC not getting back on defense.
See if we can see one of those buzzer beaters.
McCarthy should take it himself. Pope, cross court. Extra pass.
He's going to get it off.
Three. No. I thought they made one extra pass too many. But anyways, it was good. They had Mendez for the open shot where he likes it over there, kind of falling away. But anyways, BCC all over the Roxbury Tigers here at the half. So at the half, 48-17, BCC with a huge balanced attack. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here at Bishop Conley. Bayhawks got the lead. Tune in next for the second half. We're getting ready to start the second half. Craig, what did you see for BCC? What made them so successful against this Roxbury team?
What did I see? Pure domination, plain and simple. We talked before, Roxbury, they have no bench, so their five players are already getting tired. BCC just running circles around him, doing everything right. Great passing, great shooting. We've seen this a lot from BCC, but now it's really just pure, like I said, just pure domination at this point.
Definitely pure domination. Kind of like what we've seen in the women's game earlier on, where Roxbury came in as the number one team in the region, going against an underwoman team. Only six BCC, the women's team only has six players, and they got blown up the court. BCC men's return the favor. Three-point shot off the top is good.
Well, Roxbury drawn first blood in the half, so we'll see if that has any effect on them.
Yeah, Pedro Ramos with a three. 48-20. Mercado looking to drive baseline. Gets caught underneath. Yeah. Hits the backboard. Going to be going Tigers' way. Yeah. BCC can't get too lackadaisical here. They had a great first half. But they can't get too lackadaisical. The Tigers will get back in this thing.
It's a 28-point game, which isn't impossible.
Cherry driving to his left at the lane. Kicks it back out. Three-point shot. No good. Tigers with the rebound. Jumper, Mosley, it's good.
BCC maybe getting a little lazy on defense.
I think it can happen psychologically where you're up so much. You know, you go to halftime, it's a long half. Baker on the baseline, gets caught underneath, gets it blocked. And the Tigers coming. Hassan kicks it back out. Three-point shot, no good.
Goes right into the hands of Jose Mercado.
Mercado scoops a nice pass to Baker.
See, that's what I'm talking about with this Bayhawks team, just picture-perfect passing. You know, they got the three Ps of the team, the picture-perfect passing.
Yeah, great passes by BCC. Driving, trying to, not sure what Ortiz was trying to do.
Nope, he just tasted the floor.
McCarthy back out to Mercado for three, air ball. Jernigan on the baseline. No good. BCC doing all kinds of weird things, hitting the backboard. That one goes over the backboard or hits the top of the backboard. Tigers basketball. Three-pointer by Ortiz. It's good.
So this one's now cut down to 25 points.
Coach Del Lu going to get a timeout here as
Yeah, probably a smart move because this is BCC's game to win, but the second half, they're just not really showing it right now.
And what was the score at the half? 48-2?
It was like 48-17.
48-17. Tigers coming out here in the second half on an 8-2 run. Coach Rob Del Lu not happy Rob DeLue in his eighth season as a head coach. Over 100 wins now. And since the inception here, Rob DeLue, he's the only thing that BCC has known for the head coach. 100 wins that he reached back on the December 10th of last year. He's got a lot more wins than that now. BCC looking to get back to the regional championship game. That's what it's all about right now. Bayhawks finished runner-up in the state championship last year and in Region 21. So BCC looking to just build and build as we get towards February. And BCC also on the road, as the women's team is. Three games, next three games on the road. We won't have another game until February 7th, Craig.
Yep. Like I said, our post-Super Bowl reactions.
That's right. Baker, back up top. Mercado swings it to McCarthy. Jernigan, look at the ball movement. McCarthy, the jumper, no good. Love the unselfishness and love the ball movement. Everybody getting a hand on the basketball. Staying in the game. But BCC can't connect on that when it goes out of bounds. Breaking the trap is the Tigers.
And Roxbury showing off some good passing.
Yeah, but the ball goes out of bounds. BCC basketball. McCarthy at the top, run the point. Dumps into Jernigan. Look at the way they move it. All starts with McCarthy at the top. That's what it feels like. Everything goes through him. Love the way that Baker positions himself. It's a surprise that so many teams almost let him get the position, let him get the ball. He doesn't get the ball on the block. He kind of gets it right on that baseline, right between the block and the baseline. And then he's got a quick step and a quick jumping ability.
I think that the other teams, I think they're sleeping on him.
They sleep on him. Like, he just hides right in that sweet spot. I'm telling you, man. Armani Baker leads the team in scoring and rebounding. Over 17 points a game. He hasn't even been the factor. He hasn't even been the man today. Driving his cherry, somehow gets in the lane. No good. Baker altered that shot. Mercado going down, loses control of it. That was a hell of a pass.
That would have been very impressive had that worked.
Yeah, hell of a pass by McCarthy. Yeah. Ortiz ducks, three-point shot is good. Mm-hmm. How about the Tigers shooting from the outside?
It's good patience off the shot.
Tigers an 11-4 run early on the second half, a lot of time. Love how they flash. They flash Jernigan up top. Baker down to Jernigan. Cross pass. McCarthy, no good. Baker underneath. Rebound, no good. Tips up, no good. Baker's such a quick leaper. He's able to create second and third opportunities for himself. Even when he misses once or twice, He's up and off the floor quicker than anybody.
Yeah, that was a surprising amount of chances that BCC had.
Yeah, he's like a jumping jack. He's like a jumping bean. BCC's going to turn the ball over.
This has not been
Roxbury basketball.
This has not been BCC's half.
Ramos
first,
for three. Bangs it home. What in the hell is going on? 52-31. 16 minutes to play.
BCC just needs a good possession right now.
They definitely do.
And they
jumper,
get that.
Jumper, Jernigan.
Ask and you shall receive. They got that good possession.
Hello, Jernigan going the other way. Jernigan in the open court. Puts it above the glass and in. Nice steal by Jernigan at the half court line. And that's what BCC needed to kind of weather that storm. Back-to-back baskets by Jernigan.
Yeah, they were playing sloppy early on, but that might be what they need to get back into this thing. And it's kind of tough to say get back into this thing when they're leading by 25.
Yeah, they are already in this thing. BCC. Jernigan coming in. Off the glass and in. How about Desmond Jernigan? And Desmond Jernigan single-handedly extends this thing back out to 27 with 15 minutes to play. And getting a timeout is Coach Jelani Townsell for Roxbury. So 58-31 now. BCC was kind of going through the motions there at the beginning of the second half, but reasserts themselves. Desmond Jernigan, three consecutive times down floor, you know, scores baskets. Six quick points for DJ. And we'll keep it right here at Bishop Connolly High School.
Talking again before these timeouts, give Roxbury a chance to rest.
I don't think they could have all the rest in the world. It doesn't matter at this point. I think they had that. I think they had their shot. They pulled within what, 22 or so?
Something like that. I think it was 20. I think 21 is the closest.
21. You take away the 6 points that Jernigan just scored. It was 52-31. They were on a 14-4 run. Hitting a few threes there. Jared Ramos with a couple threes.
Yeah, but they need something to keep them from dying on the court.
Yeah. Yep. Sherry walking the basketball up for the Tigers. Oh, man, that should have been a travel.
That was blatant. I don't know how we got away with that.
Sherry up and under. And they're going to call steps. That's like a makeup call.
Still, that one wasn't even as blatant.
That wasn't even as blatant. That was a good up and under move. Nice head fake there, but they call steps.
Delayed call, perhaps?
Roxbury in zone. Oh, nice cut. Nice pass by Baker to Jernigan, cut into the hole. They get a good thing going.
Yeah.
They get the ball on the baseline. They get the ball in the corner to Baker and Desmond Jernigan. Cutting to the basket, cutting from the free throw line.
Yeah, we've been seeing this play quite a few times, and if it's going to keep working, then why not? Jernigan up with the and one.
It's either Jernigan finding a cutting Baker or Baker finding a cutting Jernigan. Those two playing going hand in hand there.
We talked about one thing with this team is so many guys mirror each other, and it's great to have two guys like that on the court who both can do that.
Yeah, two forwards. Nice spin and in the lane, number five. Jabril Hassan. Jernigan back up top. Here we go again. Right there.
Oh, they realized it that time.
Oh, that would have been a nice behind the bounce. Nobody was there, though. I think he was hoping that Baker was there. Just sailed out of bounds. Nice pass. That's thought. Would have been a brilliant pass by Pope.
The Pope of Hope.
Pope's got skills.
That he does. This does pretty much everyone on this team.
Driving to his left, Cherry back out to Ramos. Loses it.
Shot clock's winding down.
Ooh, good job keeping his pivot foot there. Two on the shot clock, three-pointer, buries it. This guy, number 14, Pedro Ramos with his third three. Going back the other way, easy lay and not getting back on defense. Shame on Tigers. Shame on Roxbury.
Nope, Bayhawks just saying I had enough. Get the quick 2 points.
Looking to set a pick.
Bayhawks have done a good job making Roxbury run down the shot clock.
Yeah, that's what they do. They do a good job of doing that. Oh, almost up and down. Driving baseline is Cherry. Ooh. Trying to will his way to the hole. BCC, they haven't had a lot of fouls today. That's good defense when you are keeping your feet, keeping your positioning. And not a lot of fouls. Only one foul so far here in the second half by BCC. Three team fouls for the guest Roxbury Tigers.
McCarthy second personal, and like I said before, it was a great job winding down the shot clock. That was their second time in the second possession that they had it come down to the wire.
Yeah, so, BCC forces you with their defense, especially when they're in man-to-man. They force you with their defense to hold on to the ball, make the other team unsure of themselves, and just not. They just don't allow easy shots, easy baskets.
Yeah.
BCC's so athletic, too, so quick. They get a lot of steals. They force a lot of turnovers.
That's the thing. They're so fast, and they're making the other team run. So you're playing a fatigue team. They're so fast, they can just run circles around them.
I love the offense right now. I love the way they're swinging around the perimeter. They flash the one big guy high. There's Mendez for three. No good. Yeah. Oh, Baker coming away with it. Tried to get it to Desire. And I believe Desire is going to get fouled there. Or not.
They're calling a foul. I don't know if Desire's going to the line.
What BCC is doing, they're flashing one of their big guys up to the free throw line. They swing the ball around the perimeter. They occasionally get the ball to the top to win their forwards. But they always have a forward down low. They get it to the big guy up top, and then they're looking for another cutting, usually Baker or Jernigan. Or Desire, they're flashing up, but one big guy stays down low, and they're looking to get the ball inside. And they have good passers. They could do that. They got good passers. Their big men are good passers.
Like I said, one of the Bayhawks' best assets of this game has been their positioning.
Driving to the lane. That's going to be Cherry for another hoop for him. 63-39. Mendes thought about three. Jumper, mid-range jumper, no good. From the free throw line, no good. You don't see a solid mid-game anymore, mid-range game. Cherry going to the hole again. He's starting to get in the groove.
I agree with you. It's all either driving or it's all 3 points.
It's either all or nothing.
I blame Steph Curry,
but it's way before Steph Curry.
I just blame Steph Curry.
Again, get it down. Baker, cross court. They'll swing into the corner. Pope for three. No good. Rebounded. Baker, again, tips it up. Second chance point for him.
I don't think we've seen BCC make a three in a while.
That hasn't been their offense today. Their offense has been driving, cut into the hole. BCC still working hard on defense. Mendes guarding Cherry, 12 on the shot clock. Dribbling and bibbling. Driving to his right. Goes back out. Mendes all over him. Ramos thought about three. Back out. Got to put it up. Three-pointer. No good. Rebounded by Baker. McCarthy up ahead to Desire. Puts it up and gets it. Gets it to go, and he's going to get fouled. BCC bench liking it.
The Roxbury bench is absolutely silent.
As I look over, no one's there. That's funny. You got me to look. I was looking to see some sad faces.
No, if you want to see sad faces, it's on the court.
Free throw made. Three-point play, old-fashioned way, completed by Kevin Desire. KD. That's a bad pass and a bad decision by Cherry. Knocked away by Pope. He gets hit in the face.
I think it knocked out his contact lens. Yeah, it knocked out his contact lens. Look, he's putting it back in. That's something you don't see every day. No one reset the shot clock.
68-41.
Hate when basketball has technical difficulties.
Yeah. Always here. Oh, nice pass. See? They get the ball into Desire. Finds a cutting Quincy Pope. Beautiful play. Beautiful execution. Nice pass by Kevin Desire. He's liking it.
God, if I had a dollar for every time one of us has said nice pass this game, I'd be able to pay my college tuition.
At BCC, that shouldn't be that hard to do. 70-41 halfway through the second half. And, man, it's been all BCC. Roxbury came out, kind of balls of fire, went a little 14-4 run, but six straight points by Desmond Jernigan kind of reset things. And, man, everybody getting in on the action.
That's great to see everyone do their part.
Look for the Dirty Water Sports Hour here on Channel 95 as we just record in the studio yesterday. Look for that in your local listens, the Dirty Water Sports Hour with Cardozo and Andrews. You can hear us on BCC Radio at 4 and 7 p.m. on Thursdays. But off the times, we'll simulcast it, and you can watch us. This past Wednesday, we recorded, and we were talking about the Patriots' AFC Championship win against the Steelers, and also talking and looking forward to Super Bowl 51, Patriots and Falcons next Sunday. Looking forward to it. Ortiz, that's a deep three, way off, rebounded by Baker.
That was one of the more times, or they had more time on the shot clock than they've had the last few possessions. That was just careless. I think they just had a brain cramp on that.
Pick set. Foul, I think that's going to be on Baker.
Yep, foul on Baker, his second. Third team foul of the half. Now it's another foul. This time it's on Kevin Desire. So Pedro Ramos, he's going to the line.
You say Ramos, I say Ramos. Ramos. Calmly sinks that one. Nine minutes left to play. All right, Baker and McCarthy will come out. Jernigan, Mendez, Mercado are in, along with Pope and Desire to round out the five out there right now for BCC. BCC looking for their 10th win in their last 11 games. Both free throws sunk by Ramos, 70-43. Mendez back out to Pope. Pope cross court, Mercado. Mercado for three, gets it. Jose, can you three?
Yeah, Pope's like a sharpshooter with those passes across the court.
They do that cross court pass all the time, and Ricardo's always sitting there wide open.
It's always chest level.
Loose ball on the floor.
Up, Tom Brady fumble.
Tom Brady fumble.
Remember when they tried to call that?
Yeah. Not sure what happened on that play.
I know.
They're saying that they had a recovery, and they didn't say that. Then they said they didn't have a recovery.
Yeah, something like that. I know here, Amir Ortiz is mad, kicks the bench or the bleachers. I don't know what the bleachers ever did to him, but
look the way they do.
They look the way they do.
Beat up.
Be as very uncomfortable as they are. You make fun of me for the selfies before.
Yeah, it's my first. Wait a minute, I don't think that even came out, man. What the heck?
Took the. I think you took from the face cam.
Yeah? All right.
There we go. When you get back-to-back blowouts, this is the kind of fun you have.
Hey, I'm learning the selfies from you and Lucy. I used to be a selfie king. I kind of calmed it.
Yeah, it grows on you. It was a pass to nobody.
Mosley jumper is good. Mosley left wide open for that one. 75-45. Pope on the other end lays it in. Drops a dime. On a dime. 77-45. BCC constant with that defense.
BCC this half's been consistently leading in the 20s. Now they've broken the 30 mark.
Cherry with the miss. Mercado to Mendez. Mendez from the elbow. Jumper, no good. Rebounded by Cherry. Long pass. Gonna be deflected. Mercado going strong to the lane. Look at it jam, and he missed it. Boy, Mercado took it all the way. Should have made a poster out of Roxbury, but
he wanted to slam it.
Oh, nice pass by Ortiz. Nice way to drive the lane and drop it off to Mosley. Mercado just does everything well.
It's the man bun.
Yeah. He could drive, he could dish, he could shoot. You know, he's not the primary ball handler, but he can handle. And pass. Three-point shot by Mercado. It's good. Once again. Jose, can you three?
You saying he can
for
do
three?
You saying he can do everything, and shooting is definitely one of those things.
That's it.
Danny Mendez gets his second foul of the game.
Yeah, Jose Mercado. Boy, has he been good. Getting inside, working hard as Mosley missed it. Here's McCarthy. Roxbury in 2-3 zone. BCC has dominated that zone today.
That they have. It's been working extremely well for them. So why not?
They've been able to find the holes in the zone. Like, they get it underneath. Nice pass by McCarthy. And working underneath is Armani Baker for two.
Just always able to thread the needle. That's been their specialty this game.
And Baker's a forward. And I swear he's just undersized. But he finds a way to score underneath there. He's got the up fakes. He's got the leaping ability. He finds a way to make it work. And it's 82-47.
You see, one thing with this mashup, the Bayhawks have had history on their side as they're coming in 7-1 against Roxbury in the last eight games dating back to the 2013-2014 season. So definitely looking to make it 8-1, and with 5:40 left and this kind of a lead, it definitely looks like they can do that.
Their last loss coming against Roxbury was on February 28th of 2015. I believe I was there. That was in the tournament. That was in the regional tournament championship. They lost 91-86, if I can recall.
I was still in high school. It was my junior year, and I hated everything, as most juniors do.
You were a junior in high school in February
2015? Yep.
Man, I'm an old bastard.
It was only 2 years ago.
Yeah.
I'm a youngin'. I'm only 19.
I know, you're only 19.
I can't even drink in America.
That's why we can't call you the Portuguese Terror then after 8 p.m. Well, now it is after 8 p.m.
Yeah, it's
almost 9:30. We got to be careful with that.
What makes me the Portuguese Terror?
I don't know. You tell me. We have to keep that under wraps.
It's top secret information.
Yeah. Missed by Ortiz. BCC right near their season average right now. Nice dish by McCarthy to Baker.
This is just getting ridiculous.
McCarthy driving the lane and finding Baker. I mean, it's just a great effort by BCC today. Complete game. Driving the lane is Cherry. Ooh, rebounded by Mosley. Mosley getting pissed off.
I don't know how Mosley came down with that.
Where was Mosley in the first half playing like that? Mosley has just got a, I don't know, he's just got a chip on it, just got a chip on his shoulder here in the second half. He's been playing big for them. I'm not sure where that intensity was in the first half, but he's found it here in the second half. It's going to be a little bit too late, though.
McCarthy's definitely taking his sweet time.
Floater. Oh, and rebounded is who else? Armani Baker there to pick up the scraps. Yep. The Baker man. And it's sizzling in this gym once again.
Right here in the sweat box.
Here at the bakery. Coming to the lane. Floater blocked. Blocked by Espinoe. Mercado pushes up. Goes to Bricotti, flips it, inside. Oh, goodness. The Baker man once again heating up.
Yep, definitely showing what the Baker's cooking.
What a dish by McCarthy, finding a trailer, finding Baker. BCC always has someone cut into the hole. They always have a trailer. BCC always with great court awareness.
Oh, Baker almost had a great steal.
And they're going to count that basket by Cherry. Cherry probably their leading scorer. I feel like he's on. Where the heck is he going? Where is he going? Do you know? Do you want to shoot the shot or what? I feel like Cherry's done a lot of work. Done a lot of work in this game to get very little.
It's the Jamie Staples of the team.
Yeah, just like you know that he's probably the best offensive threat on this team. You feel like he's always has the basketball. He probably has close to 20 points in this game, but I feel like he's done a lot of work to get nothing.
So it's Kobe towards the end.
Yeah, something like that, where he gets a lot of shots, but he's not scoring as much as he should. Or Baker. Back out to Mercado. Jose, can you three it? Another three for Mercado. Three in the second half. 91-52.
See Luis.
And this game is academic almost.
See Luis Rosario getting his first play in the game.
Yeah, Rosario in there. Rosario. And ooh. Ortiz bounces that to nobody. I think he was trying to look for Ramos, but I'm not sure if Ramos was just caught looking.
It seemed like it was a good look, just no dice.
That's something that I haven't heard in a while. No dice. No dice.
I have dice on my car. Get the old-fashioned, yeah, like the old-fashioned 80s mirror dice.
Get the Playboy dice. Three-pointer, no good by Espinoe. Under 3 minutes to play from Bishop Conley.
91-52.
Yeah. Nearly a 40-point deficit.
And just in the game, Luis Rosario records a foul.
Rob Delu still intense, even though his team is up by 38. 2:44 left to play in this one. I want to know why you don't see Ryan Stopker in this game. I know we always push the issue. put the guy in the damn game. I'm serious, man. It's okay. You're good. You could put him in there when you're up by 30. Could have put him in there a long time ago. Up ahead.
Wow, that was a great steal. Very smart by Danny Mendez. After the steal, he's staying back. He didn't just rush to the hoop. He stayed back and knew what he wanted to do with it.
And Coach Del Lou heard me. These people, they hear me. When I say something on this broadcast, they hear me. Stopka going in the game.
Yeah, I tell you, Stopka's about to drop 30 points.
Come on, let's get realistic. Let's get realistic,
15,
man.
15.
A basket. A two to match his number.
An assist.
Stopka. Stopka. It's Stopka time, ladies and gentlemen. The Scalabrini of the Bayhawks.
This is what legends are made of.
Mini Brini. Rosario going to the hole.
Now, Rosario's another guy who doesn't get a lot of playing time, so he's just got to make use of it.
Rosario's a good little player, though. He doesn't get enough run, and this team is so deep. He's a functional basketball player. He goes up there and can do some things. He's got a good shot, you know. Doesn't knock that one down, but...
I was going to say, just as you say that.
Yeah, exactly. The jinxa.
So he's going to miss this one.
Ryan Stopker in the game, ladies and gentlemen, for the Bayhawks, number two.
That time I actually called it.
You called that he was going to miss?
Yeah, I was hoping that means he would have made it.
I knew you were an awful person.
Hey, I called he missed it because I was expecting him to make it. Because like, you jinxed him by saying he was going to get a good shot.
Ortiz driving on Stopka, gets it down low to Mosley, who's playing with like a man who's deranged, and he gets fouled.
Just for the record, I called the miss because I thought it would help him make it.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I go to school with these people. I don't want to get beat up.
Come on, man. I got your back. Mosley with the miss.
Brick.
We have a tough one, Craig, for the Bayhawks player of the game. I'm going to stew that right now.
Can we just give it to the whole team?
No.
Make my job easier.
Fifteen on the shot clock. Espinol weaves his way to the lane. Misses.
Yep. 1:15 left in this
game. Look at Mosley still playing hard. Give it to Mosley.
It's like he almost broke his own kneecap.
Mosley's been playing like a man possessed. And they're going to call steps. Too many extra steps down there. Nice thought, but nothing doing.
Can't really see it on his face, but just by his body language, you know he's mad. Now we reach under a minute left in this game.
Desire gets that one picked off by Mosley. Not Mosley. That was Hassan. So BCC, two games left here the month of January, and then five games in the month of February. Craig, two home games left. Seven games left for BCC. They play at Holyoke on January 28th and at Mass Bay on January 31st and at UConn at Avery Point on February 4th and then back-to-back home games against Quinn Sigamon on February 7th. February 11th, they play against Gateway. And then they round out the season against Massasoit and Northern Essex. So five of the next seven games are going to be on the road. But the Bayhawks are an impressive. The Bayhawks are 5-1 on the road this season, so they're good. They've been a good road team.
Yep.
And Coach Rob Del Lu says sometimes they play a lot better on the road, less distractions. He doesn't know what it is, but
Bayhawks turning the ball over in the final seconds.
3-point shot falling away as Ortiz rebounded. Stopka, nice rebound.
And the crowd loves
it. Good position, hustle. Oh, Ortiz steals it from Rosario, lays it in.
Okay, 0.1 seconds. They can still do this.
I didn't realize there was 0.1 seconds left, but that's going to be it. 91-56, BCC comes out here a winner. BCC wins their 10th game in the last 11. So BCC comes out there 11-3. 11-3 overall, 11-3 in Region 21. Roxbury falls to 2-15. They lose their 11th in a row. They're now 2-11 in Region 21. So that's it. The two teams have already, did their little sportsmanship thing, but that's going to be it. So our Bayhawks player of the game, I'm going to go with Jose Canu 3, lighting him up in the second half. I just feel like he was just a man. I mean, he was doing everything. Alley-oop dunks, three-point shots, great passing. I mean, you could give it to a bunch of different players. I mean, I thought Desmond Jernigan was huge. But, I mean, the BCC team, I mean, five or six guys, I mean, just played great basketball for BCC. So that's going to be it for David Cardozo and Craig Salvador on the call. Bayhawks come out here a winner, 91-56 over Roxbury from Bishop Connolly High School. You've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. Good night, everybody.